refried beans inside the Instant Pot. Now, I forgot to film the very beginning part, so I have 1 pound of pinto beans and 1 onion chopped up into small pieces. Now, I've rinsed the pinto beans, so don't worry about that. Then I have a heaping teaspoon of garlic and a little bit of garlic salt. Next, I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of cumin. This is a half a teaspoon, so that's why I'm doing 2. Now the trick with the beans is that you need a lot of liquid. So I'm gonna do 4 cups of chicken broth. So that's 1 whole container right here. And then I'm also going to add 3 cups of water. Your beans are all ready to go. We're gonna put the lid on, make sure that it's on sealing. Then I'm gonna push manual and go all the way up to 45 minutes. If you don't have a manual, it also means high pressure or normal. Use whatever your machine has to make it pressurize. All right, so I let it stay in there for 15 minutes when it was done cooking, and then I took the lid off. So now the trick is you're going to drain out the liquid from your beans and then slowly add the liquid back in. I put 1 cup of liquid back in there, and that's how I like my consistency, and then I'm going to smash my beans. If you want it thicker, maybe start with a 1/2 cup and you can slowly add the liquid back into your beans. So my kids love bean burritos for lunches. So I like to put some foil down, then I'm gonna get a tortilla and put my beans into it. Now these are a little bit thinner beans. My kids like it better that way. But if it was my choice, they'd be a little thicker. All right, so I'm gonna put just a little bit of beans down, and then I just put cheese on top because it's just a bean and cheese burrito. Then you're gonna go ahead and roll it up and make sure you get the corners in tightly so you won't lose beans. Then I just do 1 piece of foil per burrito. So just roll it up so there's no places touching the air, and then I stick these individual things right inside my freezer.